What projects is Python ideal for? This is a question that I got from a reader, and I want to share some of my thoughts on this. So what is Python great at? I think Python is a language that makes developers very, very productive. If you compare sort of the lines of code you need to get something done in Python with the number of code you need to write to get something done in a lower level language like C, and potentially also something like Go or C++, then usually you'll find that Python is at a big advantage there. Now, you know, just the raw number of lines comparison, it's kind of not really super honest to do that in all cases, right? Kind of judging people by the lines of code they produce. People have tried to do that in the past, and it wasn't really a good idea. So take that with a grain of salt. But fundamentally, I really believe that Python is a language that makes developers highly productive. So anything that where that aspect of Python helps you, I think that makes it a prime target for using Python. So for example, if you think about rapid application prototyping, right? If you want to do a proof of concept, I think Python is a great language to do that because you can quickly get something done and quickly develop a prototype. Another area where Python shines, just because of the ease of use and the productivity advantages, and then also because of the frameworks and libraries that exist, is in the data science world and in machine learning or AI development. So Python is probably the biggest language in both of these spaces at the moment. And it is so for a good reason, right? Because it's very easy to get into Python and to learn enough to be dangerous with it, but it still has enough flexibility to do a lot of interesting stuff, right? It's not kind of locking you into a niche like R does. You know, R is another programming language. It's popular in the data science field and the scientific computing field. But the problem is that it's really not meant to be a general purpose programming language, right? Like, I guess it is in the strict sense of the definition, but you wouldn't really use it to write a large scale web application with R, although it might be possible. But, and you know, I honestly would not ever wish that upon anybody. So the great thing about Python is that it really spans a wide gamut, and it's highly popular in these two niches. Another area where Python really shines is in web development and also mostly in the back-end side of web development. If you're building any kind of database interface, a back-end for a web application, maybe you're building something that has to do with web APIs, I think Python is a fantastic language to do that. And it's really, really powerful in that regard. Again, because of the very many third-party frameworks that are available there, for example, Flask and Django, and things like Django REST framework that are great for writing APIs with Python. So I think these are sort of the three main areas where Python is highly popular these days and is highly sought out for good reason. So if you have a project in mind that's aimed at any of these three fields, Python will be a really, really good choice already. But again, I want to add here, Python is a highly scalable language that spans a really wide gamut, a really big spectrum of things you can do with it. And for example, my friend Michael Kennedy from the Talk Python podcast, he called Python a full spectrum language. And I think that's a really good term to use here, because it shows you the power of Python, where you can apply it in these niches. But if you learn Python to kind of get into one of these niches, it can still help you to get or to build up a general programming career based on Python, right? You're never going to be locked into that niche. You're never going to paint yourself into a corner if you learn Python today. If you have another Python or Python career, software development career question, then just add it to the comments below and I'll try and cover it in a future video.